Hi, my name is Keith Bunch. I'm a technician with USA Clean, and I'm going to show you how to do a quarterly maintenance on an 18 horsepower Kawasaki engine. The first step you want to do is get your propane tank inserted and turned on. We're going to run the machine for at least 3 minutes to get the oil warmed up. Okay, our next step is going to be removing and replacing the prefilter and air filter. Now to do this, you have to locate the filter cover, which is right here, and remove it by twisting the knobs on top and pulling off your filter cover. Now set that off to the side. Now the next step is going to remove the old prefilter and air filter. And to do this, you find the wing nut that's holding the hose clamp together and loosen. Now all I have to do is pull right out of there, and there's your old filter and your pre-filter. You can discard this. Now in your kit you have the new filter and the new pre-filter. Insert the pre-filter onto your air filter like so. And to install, just reverse your steps. Tighten your wing nut. Place your filter cover. And your new air filter and pre-filter are installed. After replacing the air filter and the pre-filter, our next step is going to be changing the oil. Now what you want to do first is tilt your machine back like so. Next step is to grab your oil pan, which is provided to you in your kit, and remove the cap. Then we're going to remove the grate inside the pan and set these off to the side. Next step is to take your oil filter, which is located on the side of the machine right underneath the dipstick, and loosen it, but do not remove it. Okay, once we've got that loosened, we're going to take our oil pan to the back of the machine and locate the oil drain tube. Next, we are going to remove the plastic cap in the tube and place the tube into our drain pan. After all that is done, we are going to loosen the drain valve using a 10 millimeter wrench or socket, whichever you have, and loosen it until you see adequate oil flow, like so. So now that you have your oil drained from your engine, what you want to do next is take your 10 millimeter wrench or socket and close your drain valve all the way. Then what we're going to do is replace the plastic plug into the drain tube and place the drain tube back to its original position. Like so. Next, you can replace the grate and the cap on your oil pan and dispose of used oil according to your local regulations. Now the next step after we drain the oil is to replace the oil filter. Now to do this, you want to take your machine and tilt it on its side. Now, we want to remove the old oil filter and make sure we have a cloth available ready to clean up any spills. So, we remove the old oil filter. And place off to the side. Next, we're going to take our new oil filter and a quart of oil that's provided to you in your kit, and we are going to fill the new oil filter with the oil about halfway. So, remove your cap. Fill the oil filter about halfway. Take the oil, place it off to the side. Next, we're going to take just a little oil and lubricate the outside seal of the oil filter. After you got a good lubrication on there, we're going to take an install to the side of the engine where we pulled off the old oil filter. So the next step is adding new oil to the buffer. To do this, you want to first flip the machine back to its original position. Okay, next, locate the yellow dipstick and remove from the fill tube. Place this off to the side. Now, we take new oil that you'll get in your kit and add 1.75 liters into the fill tube. Now that we've added the oil, let's insert the dipstick and check the oil level. Now that we've checked the oil level to make sure we've got a full on the full line, we're going to replace the dipstick and run the machine for at least 3 minutes. Once we've let the machine run for 3 minutes, the last thing we need to check is the oil level. Remove the dipstick and check to see if your oil level is good. If it wasn't, add more oil accordingly. Our oil level is good. And this completes our quarterly maintenance. Now don't forget to call the IVR system at the end of this maintenance, which the number is listed on your instruction sheet. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helps.